All right, welcome into the show. Creative Crypto here. And today I have the CEO of Watchtower here for an interview. I just kind of wanted to talk with him and discuss some things about the project because they had some interesting things that I was looking at. And I was some red flags I was looking at, but I'm hoping that the CEO, Joseph, can get through those today and just tell me more about the project and kind of what they are planning here with Watchtower. So, Joseph, are you with me?
Yes, I am.
Yeah,
thanks
right.
for having me.
No, thanks for joining. I appreciate it. I was just looking over some projects because I kind of dive into some of these new projects on Binance Smart Chain, and your project came, you know, I've kind of noticed it and I was looking over it and it had some interesting things, but I was a little skeptical, so I
Good
just
time.
Wanted to just wanted to reach
sure.
out and yeah, you guys were friendly in the Telegram. I was kind of hitting you guys with some questions in there last night, and yeah, they were you responded, so I give you props for doing that. So yeah, I just have your kind of just your background a little here. Just basically, when did you get started in crypto, and what is your background with crypto?
Okay, so got started in crypto in about 2017. You know, was an investor like most people. Set up my first mining rig and got into the software side of things. And ever since then, I've been in. I've made quite a bit of money from crypto, but I've also been scammed quite a few times. And that was the thing that motivated me to set up Watchtower.
Yeah, it's kind of just trying to sift through the scams. And you know, lately with all the smart contracts and the DeFi and everything, you know, people feel more comfortable with that because it's all smart contract related. But the thing is, these scammers have found a way to make those scam contracts and. You know, the
yeah.
ones with exploits and rugs and honeypots and all that. So your project
yeah.
here, Watchtower, you guys kind of are developing, tools to combat that. Can you kind of just give a brief little intro of what Watchtower is and what you guys are aiming to be?
Of course. So we're setting up a website. It's currently in development. We've got the design completed. What the website does, without giving away our formula specifically, but it scans smart contracts using API integration. We look at certain parameters such as, the percentage of the top holders, whether the contract's been renounced or whether the developer wallet has enough tokens that it should be renounced. If there's a mint function inside the smart contract, which means they can mint as many tokens as they want and sell them off and rug it in that way as well. Looking for honeypots. So our API integration tools, which our web developers are implementing, and they're getting APIs from BSC scan, Etherscan. There's certain ones we can get from Coingecko and CoinMarketCap. And we utilizing those bots, if you like, to try and find as, we're not going to find every rug or every, scam contract, but if it helps us find, 80% of them, which most people will miss, then we've done our job. So we're not like, just because we don't find a token that is a scam, we're not telling you go invest in it. We're just trying to help people prevent putting money into ones that are obviously scams.
Yeah, that's definitely something that's needed in this space, because I found myself trying to get in these contracts early and these tokens and these meme coins, and I've come across way too many honeypots and rugs, and it's just so frustrating when you think something's legit. They have all these Telegram followers and everything, and then
yeah.
you go to the coin is pumping like crazy, and you go to try to sell it, and it goes transfer just denied, transfer denied. You're like, what?
Yeah,
I didn't even personally know what the term honeypot was until this whole DeFi stuff, and so I was like, that was new to me. I couldn't even believe somebody would even do something like that, to be honest. Like,
yeah.
at least
yeah.
At least have some type of rug or just completely dump the token, but to not even allow people to sell is just, that's just the ultimate low of the low. So so let's see. So you guys, your token is going to be it's on DX sale right here. It's called
yes.
the Watchtower WTW token. And so what is that going to do with your tools? Like, how does that integrate to your tools? How is the coin gonna have value, and how is there gonna be liquidity for this token in the long term?
Okay, so with our tool, with our token, which we've put on DXA, we're in the pre-sale now. There are a couple of things I had to fix up. So I had to lock the dev tokens because if my utility was there, it probably would have picked up my own token, right? So it was a learning process there because we did a private sale. We raised 94 BNB in the private sale. Okay. And I held on to the BNB and I held on to the tokens, WTW tokens, so that we can add them to liquidity once PancakeSwap was live. Okay. So obviously that came up as a concern. People didn't realize what that dev wallet and the tokens were for sitting in the dev wallet. So I locked them. I told people they would be vested and released a small amount at a time so that we can add it to liquidity as soon as PancakeSwap is live. The token itself, it's going to help us support the website, the utility, our design and development of the website, research into how we can find better technologies to scan these smart contracts. You'll see with other websites that offer a similar service as to what we do, like everybody knows PooCoin, you can look up the chart, you can see the transactions, mm-hmm. you can see liquidity. You have to click into, certain buttons to go to the number of holders and the percentage held by each holder, right. Which takes you to BSC scan. Then you can go to Token Sniffer, which is a different website, and look up the contract and see if there's any similar contracts. So what we're trying to do is bring all of these functions together. Mm-hmm. in the one place. So, if somebody wants to say, we can do this ourselves, of course you can, but you're going to probably have to go to 3, 4, 5 different websites to do what our website is going to do for you. Right. With these websites as well, they have a tiered model. So, you have a certain amount of, you hold a certain amount of their tokens, you're then allowed to use a higher function on their website. At the start, we're all going to be free. We don't want, for the benefit of the community, we want people to be able to come, use our website and see its worth. If you own our tokens, great. It's a bonus for us. The research and development that we get from the 2% reward that we get when you sell your transaction, mm-hmm. that's going towards, continually paying for the website, hiring more people. We've got an API integration specialist. We've got a web developer, we've got front end and full stack. We've got a marketing team trying to work. And right now I've been paying for everything out of my pocket, except for maybe the PooCoin ads, which I took out of some of the funds we raised. Everything has been paid for by myself. And I'm hoping people see that, I'm being genuine, I'm putting money out of my own pocket. The liquidity is going to be locked. There's going to be tokenomics. There's going to be a 3% liquidity pool locked for 2 years. And I'm happy to lock that for 10, 20 years, really, because liquidity shouldn't be touched. It's there for people to buy and sell into the token. The reflections are 3% back to holders, 2% burn, and 2% research and development wallet. Yeah. We'll give a little summary of how you can do your own manual, mm-hmm. Research into a token. And I think, just providing awareness to the community is going to help a lot of people. The scammers are getting smarter. There was a contract the other day, which I'm still reviewing to see if I can get to the bottom of it 100%, but it was like an automated rug, where... and I believe I found it in the Solidity code. So there's, scammers are getting smarter. There's new things every day that we have to look out for. And, that's why we're here. That's why we need to, keep on learning, keep educating people to look out for these things, to stay away from scams.
I definitely agree with that. And that's what kind of drew me to your project, that, you guys are really doing that, because I think that's so needed. Because in my opinion, these decentralized exchanges like PancakeSwap and Uniswap, I think they should code their contracts where they don't allow these scam coins to even be able to submit, listings. Like there should be checks and balances in place. And that's kind of what I wanted to lead on here to my next question here.
Sure.
It's kind of a question and a kind of an idea that you guys could maybe you know, deploy in the future if you guys really want to really drive your project, you know, to the mainstream is, because right now what's big is these launch pads, these decentralized launch pads, you know, like DXSale, for example, you guys are on. And these things, like DXSale, they allow any type of contract to be on there. And so what I was thinking with your project, and what I wanted to kind of ask you and just give you the idea, is that, you know, once you get all your tools live and you got everything going, would you guys possibly be able to make a DXSale style sale where people can, you know, come in for, you know, pre-sales and stuff, but you scan when they put their token in to sell, it goes through your scanners and all your systems, and you determine, okay, this is not a scam contract, we will list that. So then you can market that you are a safe, you know, type of launch pad that's been vetted, because then people feel like, you know, oh, I can, you know, I feel more confident, you know, getting into this. Now, it doesn't mean the project's going to be a success, but at least they know, oh, this isn't going to be a honeypot. This isn't going to be, you know, some type of just scam code. At least you get a little bit of vetting there, because there's nobody doing that. There was actually a launch pad that was going to do that, and they were a total scam. It was the sickest thing. Like, this launch pad, they claimed to do, it was called DEC sale. And they had like three different projects, and they claimed, oh, we audit and verify all contracts we list on our pre-sales. But the entire thing was one big scam. And it's like, I just wish there was a real project that could do that. Is that something that you guys could possibly, you know, do? And then you could, a second idea on top of that is that when people have to list, obviously they have to, you know, you get a listing fee of the BNB that's raised, right? You get a percentage of that. And then my idea to keep your token price high and to keep that really pumping is that you would figure out a way to the percentages to where you could take half of the BNB that they give you for the fee for the listing, and you go and do buybacks of your own token, your own WTW token, and you burn it. Because right now, these, I don't know if you've been watching, you know, I'm sure you've been busy and stuff, but there's these tokens that I've launched on Ethereum and even on BNB called like Everrise, and these tokens, like,
yes, I bought in I'm one familiar called with them.
Forever Up, where they automatically buy back the tokens and then they burn it. So it's like they're adding the BNB or the ETH to the liquidity, and then they're burning the tokens. So it's like, if you guys could actually do that with a use case behind it, you know, and a launch pad style, you know, thing where you know, because these tokens are just doing that with no product or service behind it. And it's like, I feel like if you guys could do that, I mean, you guys, your token would absolutely soar. I mean, so what are your thoughts on that?
So, look, that's not built into our smart contract. Mm-hmm. So we would have to do that manually, but it's a great idea.
Yeah, even so. So manually, that's fine.
And I have been keeping an eye on all these, like Wayfurize, Everrise, and all these tokens. So I think Wayfurize is a honeypot.
Is it?
I probably shouldn't say that out loud without confirming, but so far we've seen a couple of people that have invested into it haven't been able to sell. Maybe don't take my word on that just yet. I'll have to review it after this video call. But you're right on the nail with what you said about, like, part of our research and development of what we want to do and where we want to get to in the future is, like, we didn't specifically talk about a launch pad because I think, you know, although, you know, new tokens are great and there's so much opportunity to make a lot of money on them, they're also the really high risk ones, right? So we don't want to expose ourselves, just like you said with DEC sale, where if, you know, they're promoting like this safe launch pad and there's all these scams that happen on it, then we affiliate ourselves with the scam, and then it just kills our whole project before it even starts, right?
Right.
We do want to, though, have an exchange where all our vetted tokens and you know, whatever utilities there are out there that are aligned with a particular token, if we vetted them and we're happy with them and we're confident to put them on our exchange, we'll only put them. We will not put ones that we feel are able to be rugged. By that time, they wouldn't be a honeypot because unless it's built in and an enabled function, people would have been buying and selling the token a long time before they got onto our exchange. Yep. But yeah, that is something that we have discussed with the team and that we do want to do in the future.
Okay. Yeah, so that's pretty good. 'Cause yeah, I was thinking, an exchange is good. I don't know if competing, because then you have to have liquidity and you have to have a bunch of stuff, that goes along with the exchange, versus just like a DX sale. Because the thing with that DEC sale, it wasn't that they did have scam coins, but the actual launch pad itself was a scam. Like they were And the entire thing was a complete scam.
Oh
So
wow. Yeah, so they themselves were the scam.
exactly. And I think they made the fake projects that were on there as well. So it was pretty bad. But the thing is, they got some hype with that, because people were interested in a safe kind of. Then they don't have to worry, because that's just one less research that they have to do, is go in and vet, because it takes forever, and that's what your tools are going to do, is you can help doing that, so people can use your tools to scan other tokens that might not be on your launch pad. But if you have a launch pad, not where people have to buy a bunch of your tokens in order to launch, it's just where they can launch kind of like DX sale, and then you get a percentage of the funds raised. And then what my model I was thinking for your token was, you take the fee, and you take half of that fee, and you go and do buybacks of your own token, and you burn it. And so that would create massive just FOMO for your token. I mean,
Yeah, no, I like the idea. I like your thinking. I will definitely, I can't just make the decision on the
No, of
spot, but
course.
yeah, I'll we'll
I mean, even
we'll
if you guys
have a
do it
discussion with
manually,
the team and look into it.
Like I know it's not programmed in your contract, but even if you just did it manually, so half of the BNB, let's say if a project raises 300 BNB, like you guys, I don't know what the standard percentage that DX sale takes, what 10% or whatever they take, something like that. But you could even do a little bit lower than them, or just kind of just position yourself in the market, and then you take that half, you go do a buyback, and then just it would just people would really cause FOMO, because these coins, these buyback coins, and just these meme coins in general, they're pumping to astronomical levels, and they have no product or use case behind them. And it's like, I just feel like there's this void in the market, to where if you actually had a use case like you guys have, and you have a product that can actually be used, and then you have your utility token, and then if you do burns and buybacks, I mean, you could honestly really be something special. So that's kind of just, I just wanted to give that idea out to you, because that's just kind of what I do, and I just kind of like to,
Look, you're right on the money. That's part of the reason why, I'm not going to call myself a successful businessman, but somebody who's already busy with my own company. After being rugged a couple of times, and actually being somebody who's invested in crypto for a while, actually, took the effort to do my own thing, build a team, and start this utility so that we can avoid these scams. Because, what I find, and you'll probably find it too, a lot of your friends and family come to you for advice on what to invest in. And the same answer I have for everybody is, don't rely on my advice. I can give you, ideas, but only put in what you're willing to lose. And the reason for that is because there's so much risk, there's so much volatility, there's so many scam tokens that everybody just wants to make a quick buck that they don't really, think too much or do the research behind the token itself, or if there's actually a use case, or if there's a utility. And we've received a bit of FUD on our token, and rightly so. When I set up the DX sale, I probably did it a little bit too quickly. We were really excited to launch and to get going, to show people what we had coming up. The website, the first couple of pages with the utility are almost here. So we wanted to have the token in line with that, and we rushed it, to be honest. And because of that, I feel like I've mitigated all the concerns people had. I've locked the tokens, I've locked the dev wallet, the liquidity pool's locked until the 31st of July, but I've got a manual lock function in our smart contract. So as soon as we're live on PancakeSwap, say in 3 days' time, before July even gets close, I would have locked it for an extra 2 years. And I guess people will see that, and if they see that I haven't locked it, then they can sell the token. Like, I can't rug on them. The dev wallet is locked, so I feel like people that have taken the effort to come in and actually see what we're about are the ones that are buying our pre-sale, are the ones that are in our groups. And I'm hoping because of that, we're avoiding the sniper bots. We're avoiding, you know, the scammers that are just here for a pump and dump. Right. And they're too worried about the token that they're moving away. And we've got a bunch of people that actually believe in the project and they're going to diamond hand it and hold on to it. So, you know, we'll see what happens in the next few days.
Yeah, that's all you can do. I mean, you're putting yourself out there. You're being transparent. I mean, that's more than most projects do in this space. I mean, you're putting your face out there, and yeah, you've had a successful career so far in business. I mean, you run that go-to finance brokers too as well.
Correct.
So, you know, I mean, you're definitely busy, and you know, you're committing a lot of time to this as well. And yeah, it's great to see. That's kind of the projects I like to get behind, you know, not just some fluffy, you know, pump and dump coin, something that has a use case and that's solving a problem, you know, because you guys are really going to solve a problem here with all these scams, because I just think people just, they don't know, you know, the contracts, of course. So they're just gambling. They're going, oh, this project looks good. This has hype, and they just take a chance. But it's like, if you can kind of know going in, like you said, you're not going to catch every single one, but at least you can help, you know, 90% or 99% of the contracts, you know, not be able to get scanned, and then they can see, oh, this is a honeypot. We can't sell this token. The cells have been disabled, or there's a, you know, bunch of minting functions on here, or, you know, however else, you know, you can see that on the code. And yeah, I just think, and then not only that, you know, maybe like you said, when you show the reports, because what I like about, because I use POG. I told you I use POG.finance right now. They're good. Yes. They've missed some, like I said, they missed some honeypots. But like I said, it's the way, like, I would recommend going and using their service and just kind of seeing how it looks, you know, after the you run a scan. And it's very good. Like, if you can put up that kind of the info, put the code line that looks suspicious, and then that kind of thing. I mean, that thing would really, it would really help. You know, because
yeah, that's good. And you know, the more of these websites and the more of these utilities we have, the better. You know, I think there's room for everyone. We're trying to offer it, I guess, for people that, you know, are not experienced investors. You know, for, you know, you might get, you know, a bunch of serious crypto investors that have been doing this for a long time. They say, oh, we know how to do this already. We know how to look these things up, and that's fine. Our website might not be for you, but for, you know, your average, your new investor, people that are not experienced, we're providing a service that's user-friendly, easy to see. We're doing the research for them. We're telling them, you know, be cautious. If you see that it's a rug, if you see that it's high risk, stay away. If you see that it's low risk, continue to do your research. We're not telling you just go in and invest in it. We, like POG, we might not pick up everyone. And to be honest, I don't think we will, because the scammers are getting smarter. Mm-hmm. They're manipulating code. They're doing backdoor functions. And, you know, just brushing up on JavaScript and Solidity again after not using it for 6-7 years, like, it's a new language in itself, right? Yeah. So, and yeah, like, I just felt like I was in a new world again. So I had to do a couple of new courses just to refresh my memory, see how, you know, smart contracts differ. And, like, we're learning every day. There's something new. I've asked experts in different crypto investment groups. I've had, you know, somebody help us with our smart contract who's a famous developer. You know, we've got front and back end full stack developers, API integration specialists, all these people working together to try and build an awesome utility. And to be fair, it started just for me to want to build it for myself so I don't get rugged again.
Yeah.
You know, and we realize that this is something that the whole market needs. So that's why we're doing it.
Yeah. And I definitely like your cause. And yeah, I think you guys can really, really do great things with, you know, if you guys get these products launched and these different scanners and utilities. And yeah, that's definitely something to look at. And yeah, I would definitely look into possibly doing, you know, the buyback and burns, because that's something that's
good idea.
Really, really catching on right now. Yeah, basically that's kind of all the questions I had, Joseph. I really do appreciate you coming on and explaining it. And yeah, I definitely feel much more comfortable with the project, and that you were definitely real, because, you know, like you said, the scammers are getting smarter and they make fake profiles. And, you know, when I was first looking at the website, I was like, you know, is this guy, you know, they're trying to, and the thing with the scammers is, you know, they'll try to rub it in your face, you know, like they'll put like a fake name that kind of just, it kind of like, you know what I mean? It
The
just,
group's been teasing me about that because my surname's Faker, and they're like, "Oh, you know, is this you?" I'm like, "Can you stop teasing me, please? Like, that's actually my name."
Yeah, no, and then you have the, you know,
Yeah, look,
Elon
I can
Wario
prove it
too.
from my old days back when I was at the banks.
Yeah. Oh
You
yeah,
know,
there you go. There you go.
that's
Yeah.
my real name.
All right, man.
So, stop
Yeah.
teasing me, guys.
No, yeah. Yeah, so now you know he's not a faker, he's a real CEO, and the guy, you know, the guy's here. So all right. Well, is there any last words you want to say? I'll let you go. I know you're busy. You got a lot of projects and things you're working on, so I appreciate your time.
Yeah, we're hoping to have some sort of website rollout, just the first couple of functions by the end of the month.
Okay.
Fingers crossed. And yeah, we'll go from there. The pre-sale's live now. It ends in 3 days. We did a long one, you know, to try and allow the hype to build organically rather than just have, you know, a 1 day, 2 day hype where, you know, you get sniper botted. And yeah, we wanted to try and avoid that. That was my biggest fear. So it looks to be going well. We're almost at soft cap. If there wasn't a couple of big rugs in the last few days, I think we would have hit our hard cap by now. But you know, like there was Crusaders of Crypto, they got rugged. There's an awesome project, and I know a couple of the devs there. It's called T King. They got sniper botted, but like from everything that I've seen, they were genuine. It's just, yeah, sniper bots got in there, and they've got another product coming out soon, and they've got a lot of hype behind their token, so hopefully things go well for them and on the next one.
Yeah, I'm hoping you guys hit your soft cap. Do you have a plan if you don't hit the soft cap? I mean, is
Look, I think we're almost there on soft cap. We've got a, you know, a couple of days. We should hit that, not an issue. I really wanted to hit hard cap. I just feel like yeah, we might not get to hard cap. And if it wasn't for those, you know, couple of rugs, or sorry, one rug and a sniper bot, I feel like we would have had a lot more people investing that, you know, we're part of a couple of crypto groups that, you know, we know. And I guess the China FUD that we're getting at the moment with, you know, the banning of Bitcoin all over again, I think for the fifth time this year, that's sort of, you know, put a downer on the market, and so things are a bit quiet. But I'm not concerned about hitting soft cap. I think we'll get there very soon.
All right. Well, great. Yeah, I appreciate the interview, and you know, just letting the viewers know that Joseph, he didn't request that I do the interview. I requested it with him, so this isn't any type of sponsorship or anything. This is just me wanting to get to the bottom of this project and, you know, hearing from the guy in charge. So yeah, thanks, Joseph. I
I appreciate it.
appreciate you
Thank
coming
you.
on, and yeah, I look forward to seeing what tools you guys roll out, and I'll definitely be using them. I'll definitely be using them
Of
as
course,
often
so
as I
will I.
can, and yeah, it's definitely
That's why
something
I
to
built them.
have. Yeah, because it'll
Awesome.
definitely be a great tool to have. So, all right, Joseph, thanks again, and hope you have a great rest of your day, and yeah, good luck on the project.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having us.
Definitely. Take care.
Cheers. Bye.
Bye.